Entrepreneurs Board of Investors is challenging America to pitch the next big idea during a 60-second elevator ride.
Time's up. I don't want to plummet down. I want to go up to the boardroom.
If the pitch fails...
All right, time to vote. Looks like four no's. Send them down.
Going down.
Oh, my God!
And if the pitch is successful...
Four yeses, guys. Let's open the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
Let's go! Yes! I love elevator pitch.
The judges face off to get the investment.
I'll do what he'll do, but I'll take 4%.
You're trying to mess up our deal?
Which deal you want? Us or him?
Now what you're going to do is destroy this entire opportunity.
Is the next billion-dollar company on its way up? It's Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch, presented by Sprint Business, with support from The Hartford, Paper and Packaging, How Life Unfolds, and G2, the official pen of Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch.
Going up.
I'm a little bit nervous, but I'm very excited to pitch the product. This is something that the industry has needed for a long time, that we've been asked for. We are in a prime position to deliver it.
All right, you guys, I want to make some money. You ready? Let's hear the first pitch.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
My name is Ron Tunini, and our company, Sports Engager, is a primary player in the sports fan engagement market. We've developed a highly effective tool to engage sports players and sports fans. It's a digital sports card, but it's a new twist on an old standard. Instead of a printed card of a professional player, it's a digital card of your child, loaded with stats that update automatically as the season progresses. There's 40 million sports players in the USA and 150 million fans. We're targeting a market that's highly emotionally attached to the greatest passions in life, your kids and sports. We have written contracts signed generating revenue with major companies like the New England Patriots and the Anaheim Ducks. And we have contracts in place to access 50 million sports youth names.
I may be in this ball game.
I'm asking for $2 million on a $6 million valuation. Whoa. Is there any reason you wouldn't open the doors right now?
One, time's up.
That's a serious-looking guy with a serious ask.
Yeah. Yeah. Jeez. That tie is worth more than my outfit. He's selling a third of the company? Is that what he's looking for to invest? Is it
seems
$2
million.
Like $2 million. Million. Yeah.
25%, because I'm guessing it's a 6 pre, so it'd be an 8 post.
Oh, okay. So
it's an existing company that has revenue and customers.
I'm a little confused, but the guy, you got to listen to him because of the suit. I'm just telling you. Yeah.
All right, let's vote.
Let's vote.
All right, four yeses, guys. Let's open the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
Hi.
Good pitch.
Thank you.
Yeah.
So explain the premise. Some of us were a little confused about the digital card sort of replacing the playing card for the kids. Explain how it works again. We want to make sure we've got this.
There's a large market out there, 50 million or so youth sports players. And there's companies that serve that market. Those organizations are looking for a lot more engagement. We're a transactional platform. Those companies are giving us access to those stats. Ah. We're serving the digital sports card to the children.
So you're a business to business. It's the organizations are the ones paying
for you. Well, it's B2B to C, sure.
B2B to C, but essentially.
And you already have two customers?
We have plenty of customers already. We've been in business for a while serving the experiential market of the sports world. And they said, this is a great idea. We'd love to use this product.
Can you tell me what the Patriots and Ducks have to do with it? I don't quite understand.
There's fan engagement and there's youth sports engagement. So we can play both games, so to speak.
And you have signed deals with those companies?
We have signed deals in place.
And you're getting your $6 million valuation?
$6 million pre-money.
Pre-money?
Uh-huh.
And what's that based on?
It's based on our pro forma, based on our projections, and based on the fact that if you look at what's happening, for instance, in the selfie world, there's companies that have popped up out of nowhere and have gotten 2 or 4 or 6 million members and are getting $100 million valuations. We have the market. We have contracts for the market. They want us to serve that market. So we're in a prime position to grow overnight. We just need the money to do that.
Is it the purchase of the card that's the revenue just generated from?
There's multiple revenue streams. There's national sponsors and local sponsors that can come onto the card. And then there's a subscription model. We've joined forces with a data company that can analyze the card data and can rank and rate the kids. So there's kids, you know, you don't need your 7-year-old ranked and rated, but kids that are competitive in sports might really like that. So there's your 50 million people doing that, spending truckloads of money to get their kids in
what
sports.
What has been the revenue to date, and what has it been the last 12 months?
Oh, $500,000 or so. $500,000 since the beginning of the year.
What is your first year projection?
We hope to get to $2 million.
$2 million revenue.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. What I could consider doing, and I would like to ask my next door neighbor here, Shanda, if she wants to join in on me. We'll offer you $500,000. We'll do it at the four, subject to you raising at minimum another $500,000, so you would have $1 million in total. But I would want to make sure that Shanda ultimately would want to join in on me with that.
I'll do it.
250 and 250.
All right, I'll do it.
So we'll be half, which will hopefully make it very easy for you to get the remaining money, but it would be at a $4 million valuation. And that is post-money, not pre-money. So from that standpoint, we're prepared to do a deal. Are you in?
I'll join with my boy Tom over here, if you will, because he's in the entertainment business. I'm in the sports business already. There's nothing with more fans than sports and entertainment combined. So, Tom, why don't we go in for $500,000 and we'll give you 4.25 valuation.
Is there a way we can all join together and do this?
If you do it at the 4 million post, we'll put in the 500. I have zero problem if they want to join, because that would just fill the contingency that we just laid out 30 seconds ago.
Let me just tell you this. I would gladly have him because he has great experience and Shanda has great marketing and a lot to bring to the table. But I think joining us all together, we want a lower valuation of $4 million as well. So I'd be happy to join.
Yeah. No, I would too. I mean, it's an interesting world, and it certainly is growing exponentially. So it's something, and clearly, you know, that suit sold it. So tell your wife she did a hell of a job picking that outfit.
Because he knows you didn't pick it out.
I just want you to know, she dressed you up good.
I have no problem with them joining in. There's an offer on the table now for $1 million, okay? And that would be at a four post, as we talked about. Do we have a deal?
Let's do it.
All right.
Woo. Finally invested in someone older than me. Awesome.
I'm really pleased to have the team involved. In a business like this, where it's sports oriented and entertainment oriented, it's just as important to have the right people involved as it is to get some money. So I'm very excited about that.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
Hey guys, we are building the Sonia Hall Massey, the restroom kit. So guys, we're all in about having a great time with family and friends. And all of a sudden, someone has to go to the bathroom. They get in the bathroom and it's nasty. And some of the things they need aren't there. It's toilet paper missing, it's soap missing. So we came up with the restroom kit. The restroom kit has everything. The padded oversized toilet seat cover, 3 feet of 3-ply toilet paper, hand and tissue wipe. And it's self-contained, so you don't have to worry about OPP, other people's poop. And that's great for you and your kids.
We like to say it's the first aid kit when using any restroom away from home, like when you're at work or on vacation. The toilet paper industry alone is an $80 billion industry, and millions of families travel every year. That's a lot of bathroom breaks, and they don't know what to expect until they get in there. But with the restroom kit, they have everything they need, eliminate doubt, and give you peace of mind. We sold over 60,000 units, and Magellan Catalog is a reoccurring customer. We're asking for $125,000 for 12% to do marketing.
I hate
nasty bathrooms.
I hate them. Like, this is a fight with my husband and I, because we have a 4-year-old, and like on planes and stuff, I'm like, no, don't go to the bathroom. Like, it grosses me out.
So. I just want to see one thing. I just want to see how thick that package is. Will it fit in my wallet?
I didn't hear the valuation. Or was it?
$125,000 for 12%.
You probably heard it that one time.
It's okay, sweetie.
So what is it?
About $1 million valuation.
Yeah, about $1 million.
All right, let's vote. Looks like there's 3 yeses. Let's open the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
Hi.
I have some samples for you.
All right. Thank you.
Oh, I don't get the pink ones?
We're gonna tell you about the pink one.
So the pink one is a prototype. It has everything the restroom kit has in it, but it comes with a sanitary napkin, a little bit more for the ladies. So it comes with the oversized toilet seat cover, 3 feet of 3-ply toilet paper, hand and tissue wipe, and a napkin for the ladies.
Wow.
Can I see it?
Sure.
How long you been doing this?
We got our first order from overseas October 2015.
What made you come up with this idea?
Well, we have kids. So we
told you.
And you know, people in bathrooms, they trash them all the time.
People don't know this, but I actually put myself through 4 years of college as a janitor.
Wow.
And so I know that bathrooms were war zones.
Yes.
You know, I still have poop traumatic stress from working that. I just want you to know that. So yeah. I completely understand that. Yeah. You're using your own money for this? How have you gotten to this?
Yeah. We use some of our money, and we have friends and family who invested in us also.
Your ask is sort of bizarre, where it was $125,000 at 12%. I had to pull out a calculator, and it came to $1,041,000-some.
Yeah.
How did you come up with that number?
We got it from friends and family, and they invested in us at $1,000 a piece. We just started at that number, and we got up to about $110,000.
Are you guys doing everything? The next step up is a big step. How are you going to get to that next step?
That's what we say for marketing.
That next level.
What we find is when we're in front of the consumer, we received a lot of sales. A lot of people started purchasing from us. So it's word of mouth, and also whenever we're in front of the cameras, people want to purchase.
Are you doing online sales right now?
Yes,
Protect Your Bottom. Is that your trademark?
Yes,
that's our trademark.
And so that's where we can find you?
You can find us at therestroomkit.com.
What's your price point on this? What's the price on that?
We buy them for 55 cents a piece.
You buy them for 55 cents. Where do you manufacture these?
We manufacture in China.
And how much do they sell for?
Our best market is 12 for $27.
I don't know. I like it because I have bathroom phobia.
Mm-hmm. I like it because it's a good idea. I think I'm trying to figure out how to structure this business so it gets big.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Right?
I'm out, but I keep hearing that you guys are loving this. I think it's time for you to bleep or get off the pot. Make an offer.
Ha, ha, ha.
So, guys, we love having you guys for our partners.
You know, I think that you're going to need a lot of help in marketing.
Yes.
That's not my world, but if one of these marketing gurus jumped in, I would jump in with them.
You need a lot of help.
Yes.
And I want to give you that help. And I may need a lot of help as well, so I need some room to bring other people to help me in. So I will offer you $40,000 at your percentage of the $125,000 and invite my two marketing partners in with me to close out the rest of it if they want.
I'm in.
I think the restroom kit is a great idea, and now you're gonna go protect our bottom line.
Yes.
All right.
So we, as an official offer, Tom, Shanda, and myself would like to offer you $120,000 for that 12%. It's 5,000 shorter than you asked.
Okay.
$120,000 for that 12%. Do you accept the offer?
You got a deal.
Yeah.
Woo, thank you.
Great idea.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Really good.
We love protecting. We're going to be protecting bottoms all over the universe.
Yes.
No more itchy booties.
No more itchy booties. Knowing that you can go into the restroom knowing you have everything you need. We always thought the product had unlimited potential, and now we have the partners to make sure that comes to fruition.
And now, Perfecting the Pitch, presented by Paper and Packaging, how life unfolds.
Follow up with a thank you note.
Regardless of whether your pitch went great or was a disaster, you should send a thank you note. After all, the person invested his or her time listening to your pitch. Even if they aren't investing right now, the note can set the right tone for a relationship in the future and shows that you've done the right thing over settling for the quick email.
That's what a thank you note should be.
Paper and Packaging, how life unfolds. Visit howlifeunfolds.com.
Let's hear the next pitch.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
Okay. The average residential real estate transaction takes 68 days. So if you're one of the 61% of home sellers who are also buying, there's a good chance you're going to be moving in with your in-laws or carrying two mortgages. But here's the thing. Home sellers think about selling their home 5 to 10 months in advance, and home buyers spend 4 to 12 months searching for their new home. We think these future sellers and buyers should be able to connect now to sell later. Hi, I'm Wendy Gilch, and I left a 13-year marketing career to slow down the pace of real estate by creating Selling Later. Selling Later connects future sellers and buyers now, lets them decide how they want to sell and get into an agreement in advance. This leaves the home seller months to find their new home with the comfort of knowing they're not going to carry two mortgages. We're an unbiased platform with no ads, no solicitation, and no selling of your information. And we do donate a portion of every home post to small nonprofits. We're seeking $75,000 for 3% equity to put towards web enhancements and marketing. The best agents know what's coming on the market soon, and you should know that too.
Time's up.
I think it's a great idea, but Zillow will just do it.
I like the 3% model. It's basically a real estate broker's commission. It's really an interesting...
It's not 3%. That was the valuation.
Yeah.
Right. And she's saying $75,000 for 3%.
For 3%.
Yeah, he said it's cute because it's the same as a real estate
commission. You're saying her ask is the same as the commission.
It's clever. It's a clever ask. Not smart, but clever.
Oh, my legs were shaking.
She's just being a matchmaker, or does she have any tool to help facilitate the transaction itself? Because if she's just, I guess then we have to find out by voting.
All right, let's vote.
All right, let's do it.
Ooh, 4 yeses. Let's open the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
Oh, I'm so excited.
Hey. Hi, look at those two, they're twins.
Yeah.
I got the memo.
You too, buddy.
Thank
is there going to be a report on this?
There is.
All right. Well, we all love this.
Oh, good.
Yeah, so tell us a little bit, how long have you been doing this?
So I thought of the idea 7 years ago when we decided to build and had to sell our townhouse, but we knew 7 months ahead when our house would be done. We didn't know to sell now or to wait. We ended up listing it, sold early. Lived with my parents for 4 months, who are amazing. I thought of it then, there has to be an easier way for buyers and sellers to connect if someone's always buying and someone's always selling. So for 7 years, I sat and thought about it, and we just launched in August.
Okay, so do you have any intel? I mean, how's it going?
So we started with a free trial phase, and we got 2 home posts from there. And in September, we started with our paid fee, which is a one-time fee of $15 to $30. And 15% of that goes to one of 4 nonprofits that we work with.
So how do you get a $2.4 million valuation off of that?
Which is as our increasing sales. So our sales just started now, so our first year ends in April. So if we increase by 25% each month based on the $15 to $30 sales, the bulk of it will be the $20 to $25 sales for the 3 months to 9 months of selling.
So the homeowner gives you $30.
Right, to post their home. And buyers, it's free to make an account, but you need an account to contact the home seller.
How much is it costing you to acquire a customer?
For right now, to get a home seller, it's probably like $45.
So what's the total number of people that have signed up and have paid you money today?
I have 2 homes that went on the free trial. I have 5 homes that have joined in September, and I have 75 buyers that have signed on from August to September.
So you're saying you've had 7 total people sign up for this thing? Or
right,
nine?
In my first 7.
So 7 times $30?
I've made $105.
Okay, so you have
month.
$105 in revenues life to date on this.
We have a valuation problem, Peter. Month.
I could see the home buyer. It's a great way to see inventory. Let's check things out that are before listed. But the home seller, what are they going to do? They're going to start talking to the buyer and just cut a deal and never put it on the market for the rest of the world to see it?
I think there's plenty of options of how you can sell your home, whether you want to use an attorney for sale by owner or real estate agent. The goal for us is that you get leads and then you decide from there how you want to sell. So if you only have 1 lead that you want to sell in 6 months, you might think, well, maybe I need to use a real estate agent to help me get this through. But if you have 20 leads and you have the time, like maybe I can just use an attorney and do it that way.
Okay.
But for me, I want to empower them to know that you have options of how you can sell your home, and you also don't need to have your closing date be 30 days.
But being realistic, percentage.
Peter, unless we can figure out the valuation, I'm out.
Yeah, but I wanted to understand the business model first, because if there was some secret sauce, unfortunately, I'm not seeing it.
Yeah,
okay.
Sorry, I don't know where to go with that.
Yeah,
No, either. I'm sorry.
Thank you for your time.
Yeah. Sure. It's a good idea.
Thanks. Thank you. Good idea. It's clever. Thanks. I just work on the model. Okay. I think there's something there.
Right.
I think you're a little early.
I do too.
I just don't think the way you're presenting it right now is the one that's going to be able to turn into an economic success for you.
Okay.
Think through the buyer and seller and the time frames, and I think there is something there for the pre-listing world for grabbing.
Right. Okay, great. Yeah. Thank you. My pitch went great. I think I did really well, but didn't quite go as I expected, but that's okay. You know, I've done everything on my own for this whole company, so it's been a great experience, and it's a learning tool, so.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
My name is Keith Katz, and our company is MediMixer. Statistically, children struggle to take their medication up to the tune of 70%, and it costs the insurance companies up to $528 billion per year, and a large portion of that is pediatrics. It can take up to an hour per dosage to get a child to take their medication, and sometimes shots are required because that child just won't take their medicine. Our device engages a child and gets them to take their medication in 2 minutes or less.
Do parents really use that?
Since the development of the MediMixer, universities and the medical community have joined us, including Children's Hospital of Los Angeles. Recently, we were selected to go in front of a large biomedical group where we presented our innovations in pediatrics, where we were met with Johnson & Johnson. Pediatricians, pharmacies, and even Walmart has contacted us to carry our product. We are seeking $150,000 on a convertible note at a 20% discount to syndicate our funding round. I would like to share with you the technologies that we have integrated to make this an attractive and scalable opportunity that solves a critically unmet need. Thank you.
I mean, I don't know if I fully understand what the product does.
Does it mush it up?
I think it's one of those mousetrap things, and the pill goes to and then spits out, and then you eat it because you're motivated.
I have four kids. I've never had any take an hour.
What's the price point of something like that? I mean, that's, you know.
Does it come with a hamster?
Okay.
Let's vote. Let's vote it.
Looks like four no's. Send them down.
Going down.
I was super nervous. I felt like the pitch went okay. This is a learning experience for us, so we are in the capital raising stage, and so that's what we're looking to do. My product gamifies the transaction with the child, and it gets their mind off of the stress of taking the medication and gets them to take their medication in literally 2 minutes or less.
Coming up on the next Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch.
You never give up.
There's other shows. There's other investors.
No way I'd get into business with that attitude.
Yeah, forget it.
You're not the center of the universe.
To apply for season 6, go to entrepreneur.com/elevator pitch.